We could fly a kite with our shoes off, bust on a boombox, weather never too hot. Little breeze is all I need, and off to the races, watch it fly like a spaceship. You're taking me places.
Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to talk about 10 life-changing habits that you need to start right now. I know the new year just started and it's a great time to like make new year's resolutions and everything like that, but honestly any time of the year is a great time if you want to make a change, right? You can make a change today. You don't need to wait till like the end of the year and think to do it. And if you have big goals that you want to accomplish, I highly recommend that you start these habits today, because when it comes to big goals, it's so important to set yourself up for success by creating habits that's going to bring you closer to your goal every single day. If you don't have these habits in place that's gonna bring you closer to your goal, guess what? You're not gonna get closer to your goal, or you're actually gonna go even further away from your goal. So if this is like the year for you, if you're ready to make a change, if you're working towards your goals, your big dreams, your big plans, whatever it is, start these habits today. And guys, we're trying to hit 11,000 subscribers on this channel, so if you're new, make sure that you subscribe. Okay, I'm gonna hop into the video, but before I do, don't forget to hit the like button. And yeah, let's get started. Number one is to start gratitude journaling. You have to do gratitude journaling. Before, I've heard a bunch of people say that you need to do this. It wasn't that I was against it, but I just didn't see how it could help like that much. I was just like, I don't really get what the hype is or like why it's such a big deal. I don't feel like it will really change my life. But honestly, I started doing it. It only takes a few minutes a day, by the way. And guess what? It has completely changed my life. When you sit down and really organize your thoughts about all the things that you're grateful for in your life, it puts you in a really good mindset. You're like a happier person. You're more grateful for all the good things in your life. And whenever you focus on something, it grows. It's kind of like that saying, what you appreciate, appreciates. So whatever your focus is on, whatever you put your mind to, it's gonna grow. So thinking about all the good things in your life, writing it down, thinking about your goals, and then what you could be doing to get yourself closer to your goal. All these things just focuses your mind on your goals and how you can get there. And it's these tiny habits, but they make such a huge difference, because when you get your mind to work with you instead of against you, that's when you start to see really big changes happen, because it all starts with your mind. Number two is to meditate. The main reason I meditate is because it really helped cure my insomnia. Late at night, if I just can't sleep, I just lie down, close my eyes, and I stop thinking about everything, and I just focus on my breathing, and that's like my meditation. And it puts me right to bed. And nothing has ever worked as well as this method, so highly recommend. But there are a lot of benefits to meditating, and especially if you believe in manifestation or if you're trying to reach specific goals, meditating and watching your thoughts and observing your thoughts to see what comes up is a great way to get to know you and your subconscious mind and to see exactly what it is that you're feeling and thinking deep down. And when you connect with yourself on that level, it really helps to just propel you to your goals. Number three is to say no. Say no to things that you feel like no longer serve you. Say no to people and experiences that you feel like no longer serve you. Say no to things that you know are not going to take you closer to your goal, but it's actually going to take you further away from your goal. I think this is one of the most like powerful things about growing up, and one of the best, I guess my favorite thing about growing up, is prioritizing yourself, prioritizing your goals, your life, and what makes you happy, and just saying no to the rest. Because honestly, time is such a limited resource. It's the only thing that you can't make more of. So be intentional with your time. It's valuable. Number four is to move your body. Your body is like a machine. You have to use it or you lose it. But also, again, I go back to when you're trying to hit big goals or live your dream life, whatever it is, you need to focus on yourself. You need to put time and energy into self-care. When your body and your mind is functioning at its best, you're more productive and more efficient, and you're gonna get to your goals a lot faster. Not only that, working out will build your confidence. It's gonna build your self-love, your self-confidence, and all of those things, again, will just make your life so much better. And again, propel you to your goals. Also helps with insomnia and anti-aging, okay? So you can like spend $400 on like a night cream that you think will like help you stay young forever. But the truth is, if you want to work on anti-aging, you need to wear sunscreen, work out, and eat collagen products, okay? Like, not like collagen powders. I'm talking like real collagen from like actual food. Maybe we'll do a whole video about that. Number five is to leave your comfort zone. There's a saying that your life begins at the end of your comfort zone. And what that means is that if you want big changes, if you want big goals, big things for yourself, you want to completely change your life, but you don't want to do anything new or different, you want to just keep doing what you have always done, none of that is going to happen. Doing what you've always done and doing what makes you comfortable has led you to the life that you live now. So if you don't like that and if you want to make changes, then you need to push outside of your comfort zone. You need to try new things, maybe do things that kind of are a little bit scary to you, because that's kind of how you grow as a person. And once you've done something new that's like maybe a little bit scary, then you realize that it actually wasn't that bad. There's another saying that everything is hard until you've done it. So like, I don't know, waking up early to go to the gym, that might feel so outside of your comfort zone. But once you've done it, you realize, oh, it's not that bad and I can totally do this. Number six is to set a timer for 5 minutes and just clean. I recommend doing this daily or at least every other day. And I recommend doing it at night because it's just so nice to wake up to a clean house. And you would be amazed at what 5 minutes of cleaning can do. It really like tidies the place up. Number seven is to invest in quality. Whether it's furniture or clothes, whatever it is that you're like buying and bringing into your life, invest in quality. You will save money in the long run because the piece won't break down as fast. And if it's clothing, you know, invest in quality classic pieces that won't like go out of style. Try not to buy like trendy things as much, because again, investment pieces will last you longer and save you money in the long run, but also they'll make you feel more confident. You're kind of sending a message to yourself and to your brain that you are worth it, that you do deserve high quality pieces. Number eight is to practice self-love. I feel like this is such a tough one, and I feel like everyone can benefit from a little bit of self-love. Whenever you want to achieve big things, you need to, again, get your mind right. And if you don't have the confidence or the courage, it's usually because you don't like love yourself enough and you think that you're like not worthy or that you don't deserve it. So work on that. Work on loving yourself first, work on self-confidence, and everything else will follow. We always think that first we chase success and then we'll be happy once we're like successful. But that's actually not how it works. You actually want to chase happiness and self-love and self-confidence first, and everything else will follow. Number nine is to invest. You need to invest your money. You need to learn how to invest your money and then do it. If you're not investing, honestly, you're just missing out on so much money. So yeah, you need to learn how to invest. And especially right now when inflation is like squeezing the life out of everyone, I'm sure you've felt it as well. I just feel like this is a great time to realize that if you are not investing, you're actually losing money due to inflation. So invest. Number 10 is to read. There are so many benefits to reading. Did you know that reading can actually make you a more empathetic person? Crazy. But it's also really good for your brain, and you obviously learn a lot. People spend a lot of time and energy to write a book, putting all of their knowledge into it, and you could literally learn all of it by just reading the book. So a great habit to start. Again, it also mostly I read because it cured my insomnia, and lately I'm really into like teen fiction. I'm reading Three Dark Crown right now, the series, so if anybody wants to read it with me, feel free. Okay, that's it for today's little video. I hope that you enjoyed this and that you found value in this video. If you did, please be sure to like, comment, and subscribe because it really helps the channel grow. And yeah, let me know what you want to see next, and I will see you next time. Bye! Starry-eyed and complacent. Would you catch the